this is another session of quadratic equation, and hopefully you have watched all the previous lecture on quadratic equations and doing well. Today we are going to discuss some more questions of reducible quadratic equation type. I hope you will enjoy this and you will be familiar with this type of questions by solving them. So let me discuss few more questions on which you will be able to analyze and understand the way how to reduce questions in quadratic form and thereafter how to solve this. Although what the questions we will discuss today are slightly lengthy in nature, but don't worry and don't worry about the length of the question, length of the solution, but try to understand the basic concepts which will deal with this quadratic equation, and of course it will help you to understand and calculating ability of questions like that. So don't worry, just watch this and be mentally prepared to solve some questions which are lengthy by nature but good for concept development and for developing the calculation ability as well. So let me write the first question today. The first question I am writing here today is 2 into 2x minus 1, this is question number 1, upon x minus plus 3, minus 3 into x plus 3 upon 2x minus 1 is equal to 5. This is a question that I am going to take on today. This first step here, some non-negative restrictions must be given in the question, that x should not be equal to minus 3 and x should not be equal to 1 by 2. So these are two non-negativity restrictions to define this question. So let me write the solution. Solution will be, first we have to simplify and reduce this in quadratic form. As I told you that we have to reduce first the given equation in quadratic form and thereafter we have to solve it. So first work is, just first half work is in the reducing of quadratic equation, nothing else. So we need to calculate them and analyze this. 2 into 2x minus 1 minus 3 into, so if I do calcium then that will multiply by this and this will multiply by this. Minus 3 into x plus 3 whole square, whole divided by x plus 3 into 2x minus 1 and that is equal to 5. Now proceeding the same, after simplification, 4x square minus 4x plus 1 minus 3 into x square plus 6x plus 9 a plus b whole square, and that will come up like 5 into, this multiplication will be 2x square x into minus 1 minus x, 3 into 2x plus 6x and 3 into minus 1 minus 3, so that will come. Now this is 8x square minus 8x plus 2 minus 3x square minus 18x minus 9 is 27, right? I hope you got it. Okay, so let me write this and doing this all, what is that? 5 to 10x square minus 5x plus 30 minus 6 minus x, 5x plus 5x multiplied by 5 which plus 25x and 5 3 15, so that will come. Now what will happen, 8x square and minus 3x square will be 5x square, 8x square minus 3x square, let me write one more step, 5x square 18 and minus 8 minus 26x, 27 minus 27 plus 2 is minus 25, and that is 10x square plus 25x minus 15. So this 5x square will come that side and it will be negative, so 5x square will left, 26x will be positive, so it will be plus 51x, and 25 will be positive, so it will be plus 10. 10 5 are 50, so this can be break easily. Now this is the quadratic equation and it is so easy that any student can solve. So you understand the basic purpose is to reduce the quadratic equation in a standard form. That is the basic problems and calculation in this type of question. Here, how can you solve it? 10 5 ja 50 and 50, 1 is to be break in 2 terms, 2 positive terms, of course 50 and 1x. So that can be written as x plus 50x plus 10 equal to 0. And now if I took x common, 5, x common from here, what is left? 5x plus 1. If I took 10 common, this will be 5x plus 1 equal to 0. And therefore, this will be 5x plus 1 into x plus 10 is equal to 0. So, x is equal to minus 1 by 5 or x is equal to minus 10. Either this is equal to 0, then in that case, 5x is equal to minus 1, x is equal to minus 1 by 5. And x plus 10 is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 10. And that will be the answer of this question. So, I hope you got it. Right? Okay, so let me discuss another question. Here is another question and let me discuss this. X plus 1, question number 2. X plus 1 upon x minus 1 plus x minus 2 upon x plus 2 is equal to 3. Here also non-negative restriction is x is not equal to 1 or minus 2. Otherwise function will not define. That is what I am saying again and again. Let me write your solution. To solve this question, again you have to take the LCM. So x plus 2 into x plus 1 minus plus x minus 2 into x minus 1 divided by x minus 1 into x plus 2, and that is equal to 3. So I can write here after this x into x, x square plus x plus 2x, right now 2x, so that will be 3x. Plus 2 into 1, 2, x square minus 3x, in similar way, minus 2x, minus x, minus 3x, minus minus, plus, so 2 divided by x square plus 2x minus x minus 2 is equal to 3. X into x, x square, 2 into x, 2x, minus 1 into x, minus x, or minus 1 plus 2, minus 2. So that will come up, 2x square, 3x, 3x cancel, plus 4, whole divided by x square plus x minus 2, that is 3. Now I can write it, 2x square plus 4 is equal to 3x square, and 3 into x, 3x, and 3 into 2, minus 6. Now that will come up, x square plus 3x minus 10 is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation. Now you have this plate A. Can you tell me? Do you tell me? What is that? X into x square into minus 10, minus 10 x square. So product is negative and middle term is positive. So there would be one more positive term and one negative term. So it is of course 5x minus 2x. X square plus 5x minus 2x minus 10 is equal to 0. So if you took x common, x plus 5, if you took minus 2 common from here, x plus 5 is equal to 0, right? So x plus 5 and x minus 2 is equal to 0, and therefore x is equal to either minus 5 or 2. These are the two answers. When x plus 5 is equal to 0, then x is equal to minus 5, and when x minus 2 is equal to 0, x is equal to 2. So two solutions came here, and in each of these quadratic equations, and hopefully you are enjoying this, you are able to understand this. Now let me write some new questions. So what are those questions? Let me explain. So here, next question is question number 3. What is that? Let me write here. 2 times of x minus 1 upon x minus 3 plus 7 times of x plus 3 upon x minus 1 is equal to 5. Here also, what would be the non-negative restriction? That x should not be equal to 1 or 3. Right? That is the conditions usually given. And what is the maximum right? Solve for x. Solve for x. That is what may be possible, right? solve for x. Now let me write through solution. Solve for x, this is again we have to do the same thing. X minus 1, x minus 1, x minus 1 whole square minus 7 times of x plus 3 into 7 times of x plus 3 into x minus 3, right? That may come, and in denominator it will be x minus 3 and x minus 1 is equal to 5. This will come up like 2 times of x square minus 2x plus 1 plus 7 times of x square minus 9 a plus b, a minus b, a square minus b square. That will be x square minus 3x minus x plus 3 is equal to 5. So finally it will come 2x square minus 7x square minus 5x square, right? And 2 to ja, let me write more, one more step. 2x square minus 4x plus 2 minus 7x square plus 63 and whole divided by x square minus 4x plus 3 is equal to 5, which will come finally minus 3, 5x square, 2x square minus 7x square minus 5x square minus 4x plus 65, right? That will be 5x square minus 20x plus 15. This all will multiply by 5. Now, this 5x square will come this side, it will be positive. So, 10x square minus 4x will come here and this side it will be positive. So, what is remain? Minus 20 plus 4 minus 16x. And this will come this side, it will be negative. So, what is remain? 50 is equal to 0. Now, is there any common thing which will divide? Yes, 2 can divide all of them. So we can write 5x square minus 8x minus 25 is equal to 0. So finally the equation is this. 25, 5 ja 125, but 8 product of that is 125. That is not looking good here. And how to deal with this 25? Can have factors so that their sum is 8. That doesn't look nice. So we have another option. What is that? Mask, you know? So what to do? Go for quadratic formula. It doesn't look nice to have a factor like this so that the product would be 125. So we can have another quadratic formula. What is A? 5. What is B? 8. What is C? Minus 25. So we can calculate D. And D is D square minus 4AC. Remember now? Did you remember? Yeah, I hope so. So that will be 8 square minus 4 into 5 into minus 25. That is 64. And 25, 4 is 100 into 5, 500. 564. Right? So 564. What will be the square root of that? We do not know still, but we have an idea that what will happen, what can happen maximum. So let me write here something. X is equal to minus b plus minus root under d by 2a. This is the formula. So we can write minus of a. B is minus 8. Minus 8 in fact. B is minus 8. So minus 8 square is also 64. Where there doesn't make difference, but here it will make difference. Yes. 564 divided by 2 into 5. So that will come up 8 plus minus. I can write 2 into, because 4 can divide this. So 141 divided by 10. If I put 2 common, this will come 4 plus minus root 141 divided by 5. So two answers came here, 4 plus by 5 plus root 41 upon 5 and 4 by 5 minus root under 141 by 5, and these are two answers of the question. So we can have answers like this. So basic thing is that you have to find that how to simplify the questions. If even big questions are given, you can simplify it well, and thereafter solving quadratic equation is either by factorization or by quadratic formula. That is not a big issue for you, I think so, right? Okay, so should I go for some more questions? let me write some more questions so that you must be familiar, and without failing to reduce the quadratic equation in general form, you will be able to solve the question. So some more examples I am taking here for you. Okay, so question is, now here question is, let me write here, 4x minus 3 upon 2x plus 1 minus 10 into 2x plus 1 upon 4x minus 3 is equal to 3. Similar like question. That is not a big issue. Here this is a similar like question, and we can deal with this. Here, that kind of questions, how to deal with? This is 4x minus 3 whole square. Or there is some other idea. Let me tell you with some other idea. How to deal with such question? If there is such question, I am working now for a great idea. You can also solve, because my purpose is to give you the maximum possible knowledge for solving this. If I consider this, because these are reciprocals only, you know. So I can write here, let 4x minus 3 upon 2x plus 1 is equal to y. Then a reciprocal of that, that is 2x plus 1 upon 4x minus 3, can be written as 1 by y. Is it? Do you think so? Yes, sir? Okay. So I can write that whole expression is y minus 10 into 1 by y is equal to 3. That will be y square minus 10 whole divided by y is equal to 3. And that further can be written as y square minus 10 is equal to 3y, y square minus 3y minus 10 is equal to 0. And now y can be calculated like y square minus 5y plus 2y minus 10 is equal to 0, or y if you took common, y minus 5, 2 can be taken, y minus 5 is equal to 0. So this implies y minus 5 and y plus 2 is equal to 0. So y is equal to either 5 or y is equal to minus 2. Now further you can solve this using this fact. When y is equal to 2, when y is equal to 5, then 4x minus 3 upon 2x plus 1 is equal to 5. Right? That is 4x minus 3 is equal to 10x plus 5. That is 4 will come this side, 6x will be equal to minus 8. 5 will come this side, or even 10 come this side, it will be minus 6x, and 3 will go this side, it will be 8. So x is equal to minus 4 by 3. One answer. When y is equal to minus 2, in that case I can write 4x minus 3 upon 2x plus 1 is equal to minus 2. 4x minus 3 is equal to minus 2 into 2x plus 1. So 4x minus 3 is equal to minus 4x minus 2. 8x is equal to 1, and x is equal to 1 by 8. So there are two solutions. One is 1 by 8, another is 4 by 3, minus 4 by 3. So two solutions came, either by the previous method or by this method. Which one of you like most? First one of this method. Tell me honestly, which one is good? Whatever you like, you can go ahead with that. I have no issue. You can do any one of them, right? So now the next question is, let me write some more questions of the similar type so that you will be familiar with that also. So let me write one more question of the similar kind, so that this method will be also as perfect as the previous one. 2x plus 3 upon x minus 3 minus 25x minus 3 upon 2x plus 3 is equal to 5. This is the question. So again I can write it. Now be bit shorter. 2x plus 3 upon x minus 3 is equal to y. Let this is equal to y. So given expression can be written as 2y minus 25 1 by y is equal to 5. And that expression will come like 2y square minus 25 upon y is equal to 5. And finally it will come like 2y square minus 25 is equal to 5y. 10y and 5y, that can be further break into 2y square minus 10y plus 5y minus 25 is equal to 0. If I took 2y common, what is left? Y, isn't it? And now if you took, check 2y common, what is left? 5. Plus if I took 5 common, y minus 5 is equal to 0. So there are two factors, y minus 5 and 2y plus 5 is equal to 0, and therefore y is equal to 5 or y is equal to minus 5 by 2. Now you can proceed with when y is equal to 5. When y is equal to 5, what will happen? What is y? 2x plus 3 upon x minus 3 is equal to 5. That further will come 2x plus 3 is equal to 5x minus 15, or 3x is equal to 18, x is equal to 6. Right now? 15 plus 3 18, 3x is equal to 18, x is equal to 6. One answer has been derived. The other answer will come when y is equal to minus 5 by 2. Let me write what we have taken y. Y is this one. So you may take 2x plus 3 upon x minus 3 is equal to minus 5 by 2. Right? 2 multiply this side, that will be 4x plus 6 minus 5x plus 15. 6x will come this side, 9x is equal to 9, x is equal to 1. So there are two answers. One is x is equal to 1, and another answer is x is equal to 6. This has been already derived. So answer will be, two answers will come. So I hope these two methods are consolidated now, and you will be able to use any one of them to analyze this. If the similar kind of questions are there, two reciprocal of this, you can take it y, and that easily can be derived. Instead of multiplying this, then what is coming out? A plus b whole square, then apply the formula, two quadratic, one quadratic, one quadratic, denominator also coming in quadratic form, it will be linear, I hope so. Agree or not? Agree now? But in this way, there is only one quadratic equation which will be in simple form. So if big problems are there, you may split into a small segment, and thereafter you can solve it. Got it? So it will be better idea to go ahead with this. Let me discuss one more question. On the basis of that, you will be able to answer some questions from your books, respective books. You can pick on any books, any material which you like, any book which is recommended by your teacher in your schools or college or class or coaching, whatever, you can use them and you can solve them. So all of that can be solved easily. Now let me write one more question. That is question number 6 for today class. X plus 2 upon 2x minus 3 minus 9 into 2x minus 3 divided by x plus 2 is equal to 3. This is the last question, but I would like to answer by you. Will you answer this question? Will you answer this question? That is a similar why. And two methods I have already discussed. You can adopt any one of them and you can solve them. Will you do that yourself? Or should I do? Will you do that? Or should I tell you? Okay, let me tell you. The last one, I hope, I am sure, I have full confidence that you will solve it your own. But let me solve this last question for you, and thereafter I conclude this class today. So, ladies, right here. So, let me solve this. This is the question, solution of this question is 2, again I can take, let x plus 2 upon 2x minus 3 is equal to y. So the given expression can be written as, the given expression can be written as 2y minus 9 into 1 by y is equal to 3. The whole expression can be written as n equal to 0. Here also some non-negative characteristic, since is already given. You try to understand this, what will be that? X cannot be equal to 3 by 2 and x cannot be equal to minus 2. Because to define the function, this should not be happening. Now here again I can write here 9 to the 18. So can you break in these two factors like what? Minus 6y plus 3y minus 9 is equal to 0? Yes, you can. So y if I would take common, what will there? 2y if I would take common, y minus 3 left. Here if I 3 2 common, then y minus 3 left. Y minus 3 if I have taken common, then what is left? Y minus 3 if I take in common, then this will be 2y minus 3 equal to 0. So this is going either y is equal to 3 or y is equal to 3 by 2. Now to solve them, go for another one. When y is equal to 3, what was y? This was y. So we can take it x plus 2 upon 2x minus 3 is equal to y. And this employed x plus 2 is equal to, what is this? Y is 3, na? So I can write here 2 into 3, 6x minus 9, and 5x is equal to 11, and x is equal to 11 by 5. One answer is coming here. One answer came because x will come this side, 6x minus x will be 5x, and 9 will come this side, 9 plus 2 is 11, and therefore x is equal to 11 by 5. When y is equal to by 2, then in that case what will happen? If you put x is equal to 2 upon 2x minus 3 is equal to 3 by 2, by cross multiplication it will be 2x plus 4 into 6x minus 9, and that will come up 4x is equal to 13, and this implies x is equal to 13 by 4. So the second answer came here, and we have two answers, so we can write, moreover we can write the solution set like solution set is the set of all solution, nothing else. 11 by 5 is one answer, another answer is 13 by 4, and that can be easily derived. What is it? Is it enough? I hope you will solve all the questions regarding this and you will be able to complete all of them. This type of questions you will be able to solve comfortably in the future. If such questions asked in examination, you will be able to answer more quickly and nicely. I hope so. Just practice few questions or more, or the same question twice or thrice. That will be more than enough, in which you will get the two different ideas to solve one question and proceed the questions quickly. So hopefully you are enjoying all of them and you are able to solve the questions of such kind, and you will be also able to solve the questions in the future after some practice. So definitely this is a quadratic equation in middle, and now we will start solving questions related to application, that is word problems, from the next upcoming classes. So till then, all the best, God bless you, make practice again and again the same theory, watch this video again and again if you are not able to understand it, because video is a bit faster, I think so, because it has certain limitations. I can't make a video for one or two questions only. It can, yes, must contain at least 4 or 5 questions, so that it will be nicer and comprehensive study material in one video. But if some students are not able to understand it, they can revise it again and again and watch it again and again. Thank you very much for watching. All the best. God bless.